Good morning, dear children. Today we will learn, we will take writing scheme. In writing scheme, we will take informer letter. I think so, from the beginning, from 4th standard, 5th, 6th, previous classes, you have learned the letters. So, formal letter is for our class, that is the 9th class, and sorry, informal letter is for 9th standard and the formal letter is for the next year. So, in this informal letter, we are going to learn. See, informal letter, all the letter, the previous, let me tell you that we are starting. When we start this informal, informal and formal, formal letter, officially letter. And informal letter that we write with the near to our near and dear ones. Means we can write our mother, father, brother, sister, or uncle, aunt, grandfather, grandmother, or anyone. This is called the informal letter. And the formal letter, officially letter. Officially, if you want to write an application to the office or in the school, or if you want to give the complaint letters, or like this, the officially letters are there. These two letters are there. And in this informal letter, we always use, as just now I said that we use this, write the letters are near and dear ones, are close relatives and are to our friends. Now, informal letter, that is very important. That see here, the I have given here the format of the letter. See, this is a margin. This is margin. You have to touch the margin and you have to write. And in between one or two lines, you can leave here, keep gap, and write your letter. And but you have to touch the margin. Touching the margin and you are writing, not after leaving the 3-4 fingers gap and then writing. No, touch the margin and in write. Whenever if you write in one below the other, it looks very nice. See, the sender's address, then the date, then the viewer, in one line, it looks very attractive. The first impression, when you check the paper, will get that. So, touch the margin and write close to the margin. Not touching the margin means you are touching the margin. See, I have kept the gap over here. So, in this way, near to the year only, near the margin, you start the your letter. Now, the first, see, 5 things I have written for the informal letter, that is write your full name and address. That is sender's address. If I am writing letter, that is I am sending letters to somebody, my mom, my father, my uncle, so that is a sender's address. So write your full name and address. Date is also very compulsory. So below the address, you must mention the date when you are writing that letter. Now divide your letter in a small paragraphs. Divide your letter in a small paragraph. See, these are the paragraph here, the body of the letter. In the body of the letter, 2 or 3 paragraphs, small paragraph you can add. So very simple. So here you can write. So divide your letter in a small paragraph. If you are writing this body of the letter, for what purpose you are writing the letter, that divide the love. Means hardly 2 or 3 lines in one paragraph, like this. 7-8 lines you can write in the body of the letter. Those paragraphs divide and write very clearly. Keep your writing simple. Informal letter, formal letter, in both the letters, keep your writing very, very simple. Don't make it very complicated. Close your letter with phrases, and after the completing, you know, this body of the letter, that as I said, that paragraph, then close your letter with the concluding remarks. Concluding remarks, we always concluding remarks, you know, with the phrases. That phrases can be, you can see, like your affectionately, you with love, all the best, take care, give my regards. In this way, these phrases you can use for the concluding remarks. And then number 5, can use short form like ought, were, shan't, or we will, I would, in short form. In the informal letter only we can use short forms of the these words. Understand? In this way you can write letter. And here it is written here, see, once again I say that this is a very format, this is very important. In this way only you write the sender's address. Suppose I am writing letter, so I will write my address over here. Then the date is very important, that is the format. And the salutation, whenever we write the letter, we express our, you know, the namaskar, namaste, that. So if you are writing, now here I have written, suppose now dear mom, dear father, dear my friend, you know, my friend Sujata, my friend Sarah, my friend Mona, whatever is there for you. And start the letters. So take, see, when you are writing the letter, take the previous letter's background. Suppose you might have got her letter. Now suppose you got your mother's letter previously. So start writing from this. Yes, dear mom, I have received your letter 3 days back and I felt very happy for that. That is called the take the back. Little bit background of your mother's letter or anybody those who have sent previously, those you can start. Now, dear mom, I got your letter 3 days before. I felt very nice when I heard that my papa got promotion, and in this way you can start your letter. And then suppose, you know, now you are writing to your mother, then you can tell that convey my regards to papa, convey my regards my pinky and all brothers and sisters, nana, nani, kaka, kaki, you can write with that also. And that is called the concluding remarks. And the convey my regards, that is a complimentary also. And then the last is signature. Here you can write your signature or XYZ, ABC, that also you can write. Dear children, this informal letter is very easy to understand that. And one example I will give you, that example when you write in your writing skill notebook. All the writing skill whichever we are giving you, dear children, write in a writing skill notebook only. And today you write this example, tomorrow you will get the exercise. So solve those exercise in this format. Now I'm giving you one example. Please write that example in your notebook. Informal letter. Write a letter to your friend for inviting him or her for holiday picnic. Now you write this example in your writing book, writing skill notebook. I hope, dear children, you understood this lesson, and tomorrow again you will get the exercise. You can solve that. Thank you and have a nice day.